So for equation of a line, when looking at a line, this line will have an equation for it. There are two ways of writing it. The standard form is, well, the slope-intercept form, which is y equals mx plus c. Y here is an arbitrary number, same with x, or they're both variables, while m is how many units the line moves on the y-axis for every unit it moves on the x-axis, and while c is the y-intercept. So in this case, with this line here, this line moves one on the y-axis for every one it moves on the x-axis, meaning that the gradient will be one because it moves one on the y-axis per one on the x-axis. There's also the general form, which looks like this: one or y plus x equals c. In this case, you would write 1y because it moves 1y, and 1x because it moves 1x, plus 1, plus 1 because c is where it intersects the y. You can change in between this general form and the slope-intercept form by doing this. What you want to do is you want to isolate y in your formula. So what you do here in this example is you have 2x plus 5y equals 17. Then you can isolate the y. So you have 5y equals negative 2x plus 17. Then you just need to simplify it. So you get 1y equals to negative 2 divided by 5x plus 17 divided by 5. In some cases, you might have a formula where you don't have the intercept already. So to solve this kind of formula, you can find the intercept by using this method. If you have a point which you know is on the line, you can input the values from that point into the line if you know the gradient. And then you simply just isolate c as you do here. So for example, this line is called y equals 6x plus c. We don't know what the intercept is, but we know a point which is called which has the coordinates 3, 4, meaning that you input 3 and 4 in their respective values. Then you simplify, so 6 times 3 equals 12. Then you isolate c. So 4 minus 12 equals c, meaning that minus 8 equals c in this case. So the formula would look like this: y equals 6x plus negative 8. When speaking of an equation of a line, functions are very important. Functions are essentially another way of writing y, except you also show x within them. Functions basically draw their y from a domain. Well, so for example, f of x or y are the range of the domain. What's special about the domain is the domain is independent of the range. So the domain can be anything, but the range will always be something dependent on what the domain is. So for example, the y will always be dependent on what's on the other side of the equal sign. So for example, here again, the y is dependent on what x is in this case. Functions can also be used practically, which is more useful than using y. So for example, in this case, if you want to convert miles into kilometers, you can say f of x equals kilometers, while x equals miles. So the formula would look like this. So f of x equals 1.6x. Now, if you wanted to calculate how many kilometers 1 mile is, you simply put 1 mile as x. So f of 1 mile equals 1.6 kilometers per mile times 1 mile. Or if you wanted to do it with 42 miles, for example, you simply say f of 42 miles equals 1.6 kilometers per mile times 42 miles. Gradient of a line. Here you can see how you would prove it. What you need is you need a line on a graph. It can be an any arbitrary line, and then you need two arbitrary points on that line. You put up the formula for a line and put in the values for, or the coordinates for each of the points. So for example, here you have y1 equals mx1 plus c, because that's the formula for this point. And y2 equals mx2 plus c, which is the formula for this line. Since they include all the same or some of similar values, we can put them together and subtract one of these equations from another. So in this case, we subtract the y1 equation from the y2. So y2 minus y1 equals to mx2 plus c minus bracket mx1 plus c, end bracket. And then we can simplify this. So y2 minus y1 equals mx2 minus mx1. The two c's cancel out. Then we can factorize this. So since there's two m's, those are the common factors. So we can put the m outside the bracket. So we end up with y2 minus y1 equals m bracket x2 minus x1 bracket. And then we can simply use algebra to rearrange that into y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1 is equal to the slope of a line. When you have a function, it's possible to essentially move the line the function represents up or down, left or right. If you write f of x in this way, so f of x plus 1, you move your line 1 to the left, so as seen here. So this line, the original line, which is f of x equals x plus 2, gets moved 1 unit to the left, which equals this line. The same thing happens if you say f of x plus 1, where what happens is you essentially take the y-intersect and then move it up 1. The same thing goes for if you subtract 1. So in this case, this line here is moved 1 down or 1 to the right, depending on what you think. And this is done by subtracting 1 from the x in either way. Now for distance from a point to a line. Now, first you want to start with a line, which in this case is y equals x, and a point, where in this case we're going to have a point which has the coordinates 8, 4. What you want to do first is draw a line which is perpendicular to the original line, but also goes through the point that you're looking at, because you want to find the shortest line between your original line and the point. Now, usually, when doing this, you wouldn't get the intercept immediately, so just pretend that this isn't here yet. So, to find out what the intercept is, we use the method we learned before. We simply take the formula y equals negative x and input our values from the point here to make sure that this line goes through this point. So, what we do is y equals to 4, while x equals to 8, so 4 equals to negative 1 times 8, remember that this is actually a negative 1 times x, plus c. Then we just simplify and simplify until we get 12 equals to c. Next, what you want to find is the intersect between the two lines. The way you do this is by setting these two equations to be equal to each other. We already know that y equals to y, so we can just remove those from the our equation and simply set the other sides of the equal signs equal to each other. So in this case, x equals to negative x plus 12. Then we just have to isolate x to one side. So here we just isolate x over to the other side. So we get 2x equals 12, and then we simplify into x equals 12. Now to find out what the y here is, we simply can substitute the x in this formula for 6. And then we end up with this equation. So y equals negative 1 times 6 plus 12. Y equals negative 6 plus 12. And basically, y equals 6. Now, finally, we can use the distance formula. You can see the distance formula here. Distance equals to the square root of x2 minus x1 squared plus y2 minus y1 squared, and those two in brackets. Here, our x2 we can choose to be 8, and x1 we choose to be 6, while y2 is 4 and y1 is 6. We just do this because of convenience. It doesn't really matter which one is which. It's just preferable that you choose the larger number to be x2 or y2.